Today we are at Dhanbad Blessing Foundation. It's a de-addiction and rehabilitation center. So far we have seen that addiction is a bad phenomena and people get into it and they don't really want to come out of it. And why is it so? We are going to be talking to Anthony who has done it so easily, and he's going to be telling us the real face of the addiction and the phases of the addiction. So, Anthony, enlighten us about it.
Actually, now the thing is that, as you said, Anthony has done it so easily. It's not a very easy journey. Basically, first, the life of an addict. What is an addict? What is an alcoholic? He is as normal as a person who is not doing any kind of drugs. He never chose to be an addict. He never chose to be an alcoholic. He just did it on the first day with a thought that, I want to have some fun, or maybe I want to have some relaxment. He got into the trap. Now, the basic difference that I want to throw light on over here is the society treats an addict and alcoholic as a rejected person, which actually is the very, it actually stigmatizes an addict, saying that he or she is a person
who cannot
fit into the society, right? Yeah. Now, this is the factor which is increasing the problem in the society day by day. The person needs to understand that addiction is not just a mere habit, it is a disorder. It is a disorder which actually originates from a problem called OCD. It originates from that. A person tries to do a drug for the first time, he or she enjoys that drug. Now the thing is that they get that euphoria into their mind, and the mind is designed in such a manner that person compulsively wants that particular feeling again and again. So he or she tries to do it again and again. And in this process, they become dependent on such things, and finally the addict
cannot do without it. So now, we have two kinds of disorders, the addiction and people who stigmatize the addiction. So how do you tell us how to deal with addiction and how to deal with people who stigmatize these addictions?
See, before we deal, we need to perceive one thing, that addiction is a disease. It is not a habit, it is a disease. It is a very fatal disease which is right now accounting for more than like out of 10 youth. It takes into consideration about out of 6 people into it, right? Now, dealing with addiction is reaching out the helping hand to the people who are into this problem, not rejecting them, giving them a hug and giving them a scope for treatment. As today you can see, I am here sitting down in Dhanbad Blessing Foundation in a treatment process. I am the person who has been suffering for the past 15 years with heroin addiction.
Okay.
Had it not been the director of this place, Mr. Rohit Jana, who had given me his helping hand to come out of the problem, I would have been in the streets roaming about with drugs in my hand.
How did he contact you, or how did he?
See, he never contacted me. He contacted me out of his emotions. He wanted me to be a nice person. He wanted my family to get back their son. He wanted my mother to get back her support for life. So he brought me from my own home. He came to me personally. He brought me without any intentions of any profit or any returns. This is what people need to understand. Every work doesn't have a profitability. You have to do something in life which doesn't give you any kind of returns.
Monetary returns.
Exactly. Monetary return, because the entire society right now is running towards finance. Anything which has got financial aspect, we run towards it. But addiction, alcoholism is a field where you run towards people who are broken,
yes,
who are bad, who have lost their lives in a darkness which seems like infinite. Now, we have to bring them back. So in order to bring them back, we need to show them love. We need to show them that they are also a part of the family, of a society. Now, once they come into the treatment procedure, they stay away from drugs and alcohol for quite some lump sum of time. And they go through different various counseling and therapy sessions. So this gives them a break, a platform to think whether they should leave or whether they should continue.
Okay.
Now, it is the person who needs to decide. We need to work hard on that person. So,
how hard is it for the addict to come out of it? Because there are so many, you're like Rohit Jana himself said, you're just one drink away from addiction.
Exactly.
So how hard was it for you?
It is not hard. It is whether what you are being told, if you're ready to do that, it is not hard.
But then I've heard that there are withdrawal syndromes and pain.
That's a clinical aspect, right?
Okay.
It goes away within a month. Your body starts to replicate once your drug and alcohol stops. Your body starts to replicate because it has been dependent on that particular drug for a very long time, gradually over years. Now, once you don't get your drug, once you don't get your first peg of alcohol, definitely you're going to have tremors, you're going to have sleepless nights, you're going to have your diet very low. So these things will go away, fade away in a month or month and a half, max to max, no matter how long the addict has been using drug and alcohol. But the real game starts from after the detoxification phase gets over.
Okay.
Once you are fresh, once you gain back your health, your skin becomes more fairer, you look into the mirror and you say, this is not the Anthony I was.
Yes.
Now I'm becoming more, I look good. So I start to dress good. Now these things make me feel I am completely okay. And if I don't do the things which are being instructed by me, by the treatment center to me, I get back again to the same place where I was there. I start using again.
Okay.
Because the mind always tells me you have to have some fun. This is the mentality of
a But you constantly need to be disciplined. Like,
disciplined, and there are
That is again things. Also in the mind. You need to tell your mind that you have to follow the rules.
Exactly, because there are certain tools that we are equipped with during the treatment, which we have to follow once we are out of the treatment. Like writing an inventory on a daily basis,
okay.
Speaking to our counselors, going to meetings. There is a meeting, that is a self-help group meeting, where all the addicts gather and they help each other to stay clean for another one more day.
One more day until the
goes on. The story continues. Why one day? Because addicts.
One day at a time.
We are giving a very low target so that we can achieve. If we think that we're gonna stay away from drugs for 5 years,
so you break it down into bits.
Now you can do it 1 minute also.
Yeah.
You can do it for an hour also. You can do it for a day also.
Okay.
Depends on how comfortable you are in what target you are in.
How has it gone for you? Have you ever felt like you need to have that heroin, or like, you know, what was the worst moment, and what was your highest high and lowest low during this period?
Basically, initially the days were very painful. It was not very easy. When I was going through my detoxification phase, I also had argumentations and things I did which I really doesn't belong to my nature. So, but gradually, once I crossed over my detoxification phase, we live in a group living. So, 10 people were talking healthy things, and these things were coming into my ears. And I started to think about my family. I started to miss my mother. I started to miss my father at the same time. So, there is in every man, in every woman, there is a good side, which usually, regenerates once you get free from drugs and alcohol. So, these things, like my inner conscience gave me a voice. Why not this time? You are getting a platform. Give it a try. Why not this time? So slowly, obviously it's a tussle, it's a battle. It's not very easy. So, but then again, the amount of battle we have fought using drugs, it is much easier than that. It is not that high. And one more thing is, there is a self-help group of Alcoholic Anonymous and Narcotics Anonymous. This is a very big strength for us. It gives us the base platform, gives us certain instructions if we're going to follow it, if we're going to use it in a lifestyle. It really helps us to stay clean and sober.
Okay.
This is the most successful, most successful way of treating addiction and alcoholism so far. There have been many ways of treating addiction and alcoholism. Harm reduction is there. Then there is clinical treatments are there. But throughout the globe, it has been recognized as the most successful way to treat an addict and alcoholic. That is Narcotics Anonymous and Alcoholics
Anonymous. Okay. So how long have you stayed here?
It's been around 40 days.
40 days. So 15 years and 40 days. So if you go back, when are you ready to go back? Do you think you're mentally ready to go back?
See, there is no going back. I have already gone back.
I understand your question.
It's like I already went back when the day I landed over here. That was my fresh start.
Okay. Yeah.
Now, we have to be positive. Now, 15 years have gone by. I cannot sit and cry for waiting for this 15 years to come back. It will never come back. For me, this 40 days is my fresh start. I have got, if I have another 5 years of life, for example, I don't know, I'm not God, how long I'm going to live. So if I have another 5 years of my life, I'm going to make it look beautiful. I'm going to make
as
it look
beautiful as possible. Yeah.
I'm going to stand beside my mother.
Do you think like this gave you a fresh lease of life?
Of course, it has given me.
So what plans do you have for the future now? Like one day at a time, other than not doing
drugs, the only plan I have is I want to get attached to this place, and I'm going to give my service to people who are like me.
Because this
is what that gives me contentment. I've been doing it for a very long time. I've been trying to do it. And this is the way I think that's going to make my staying clean and make my recovery more beautiful
and
easy.
So that is, I think, the best way to...
The best way.
like people will emulate you, and then when people start emulating you, you know that you have to be exemplary and act good yourself. Otherwise, you'll fall down that.
I'll be safe as well, because I'll be surrounded by people who are like me, who are fighting the same battle as I'm fighting. So if I have any problem,
you have
I can
be their savior.
Exactly.
So it's very enriching and very fulfilling, right?
And it's very nice to meet a person like you who is actually taking that initiative to throw light or to make people aware about this problem. Because I have been through a lot of experiences in this field. Really, the society that we survive in, you start a project of putting in like wells and taps in villages, people are going to contribute their level best. But you start a project where you want to help addicts and alcoholics, you not have two followers behind you.
So what do you want to tell people like who are non-addicts? They are also diseased, I feel, because they are not giving their helping hand. Rather, they are pushing you into this addiction more, because they're stigmatizing you. So what do you have to say to them?
See, just I'm not an orator, or I'm not something very big, but I'm gonna tell people whichever family who is suffering from a person who is an addict and alcoholic, they never planned to give birth to an addict. And no family knows tomorrow they will have an addict in their life. Nobody knows that. So they should understand, they should realize that this is a problem. This is not just an habit. There is a self-help group called Al-Anon. If they follow those groups, if they follow what is being said in that group, they will come to have a more clear perception about what this is all about. It is available all over the net. Today, there is not a single person who doesn't have a phone. You just log into Al-Anon, you read what is being written there. There are many families who are there sharing their lives with their daughter and sons, how they have suffered, and how this Narcotics Anonymous and Alcoholics Anonymous has helped their daughters and sons to come out of this problem. And today, they are living a happy life. They are living sober. And one day of their sobriety is their happiness. So that every day they celebrate their Christmas and New Year. This is it.
So there is always hope that's the best news.
There
we all want to emanate to the world.
Exactly.
Yes. Thank you. It was so delightful talking to you.
Same here.
A very, very, very successful life.
I wish you that you get more and more followers in your channel and people watch
this
video.
Yes, I want to take this to people and let them know that de-addiction is as easy as snap and it's done.
All you need to is decide.
Take the first step, and it'll be as easy as it is. Easier said than done. I think it is as easy as that. So please, we are there to help you. Take your time out. Reach out to people. Talk to people, and it's not that difficult.
It's as easy as not picking up that first drug or the first drink. It's as easy as that.
No, you can, that depends on your mentality, it depends on your mettle also.
And one small commitment before we end this video, any further help that you need, the Mark Blessing Foundation is always there beside you, standing.
Sure, I will attach the links. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
And also that link that you mentioned.
Yeah.
Okay.